Hello everyone, me and my team work on a use case that is on L1 support works. We use robotic process automation and we work on using Blue Presenter. So today I'm going to explain my use case that is on L1 support work. First, my contents are introduction, applications and workflow. So first I'm going to explain about automation of L1 support. First of all, what is L1 support? Generally in IT industry, there are three production team are there. That is L1 support, L2 support and L3 support. So L1 support is the first level of support. L1 team mostly deals with the issues like account unlocking and password reset. If these issues are related to database changes, then these issues are passed to L2 team. When these issues are related to functionality of the application, these issues are passed to L3 team. So today we are do only the L1 support work. To automate this, we are using Blue Presenter. So in our use case, we use two different applications, that is Informatica Power Center Workflow Monitor and one is Service Desk Plus. In Informatica Power Center Workflow Monitor, it identifies the failed job and that job detail we are getting from the Power Center Workflow Monitor. From this detail and getting the information about the technician, we are through using the Service Desk Plus, we are raising a ticket to a particular technician. So first of all, I will explain how an employee will do this work. One employee will do like, first he will go to remote desktop connection, he will log into remote desktop connection, then from there he will go to the application, that is Power Center Workflow Monitor. After that, from that he will check, is there any failed job is there or not. After getting the failed job, he will collect all the information about the failed job and details about the technicians. After getting the details, that person will go to the Service Desk Plus application. That Service Desk Plus application is used to raise a ticket. Using this application, the particular person will raise a ticket to the particular technician about the job failed job and send a mail to a particular person. Like this, one employee will do when he will do manually. So this work we are doing by using Blue Prism. Our tools are Blue Prism, Power Center Workflow Monitor and Service Desk. So first I'm going to explain what is Blue Prism. With the help of Blue Prism, we can automate the L1 support work. Blue Prism is one of the automation tool under the robotic process automation. By using Blue Prism, we can reduce the L1 support team members. Like that, in Blue Prism, we can reduce the cost, save the time, and also if we want more people, then we can increase our robot. If in case we don't want more work, then we can reduce our robots. Like that we can do. So for next, Power Center Workflow Monitor. This is a tool that is present in remote desktop. It is used to monitor all the jobs which are failed at a particular point. So from here we will get all the information about the failed job and about the technician. Next is the Service Desk. In Service Desk, it is useful to raise a ticket to the particular person which person we have to consign that assignment. So here we are using these three tools, that is Blue Prism, Power Center Workflow Monitor and Service Desk. Now I will explain in how we will do in our using our Blue Prism tool. First, we will connect to the remote desktop computer and then we will log into the remote desktop computer. In that remote desktop, we will log into the Power Center Workflow Monitor application. After that, we will connect to our repository. There, we will check, is there any failed job is there or not. Next, we will, if there is no failed job, we will back to our work. Or else, if there is a failed job, we'll get all the details of the pager, then about the technician, then using that details we will go to our service desk application. We will log in into our service desk and we will create a problem. After that we will send all the information about the failure and send a mail to a particular person. This is our workflow. So now I'm going to explain about how it looks in our blueprint. This is our Blue Prism tool. Here this is the studio where we will do our graphical flow. So in our studio we have two things, process studio and this is our object studio. In process studio we have created one process, that is L1 support, and we created two objects, that is service text and workflow monitor. These two objects are used in our process. So first I will show how we work on our process. This is our process. I will show you. This is our process looks like. This first we are going to attach to the Power Center workflow monitor. Then we through credential we are logging into our Power Center workflow monitor. Login, we are using credential, we are using it is using username and password, we are saving in a data items. Then using that we are using credentials. Then we are getting details of the job and status. We will check is there any failed job or not. Then we will launch the service desk. We will attach the service desk. Through credential, we will log in into the service desk. Then we will create a problem. Then we will assign that particular technician about the failed job. Then log out from the service desk, terminate. Like this, this is our process total. So now I'm going to explain my object. What is the use of our object? So you can see these are two objects I use. I'll open this. Yeah, this is our object. First launching, this is the launch page. Here we will launch our Power Center workflow monitor. This is we will log in. We are giving username and password. Username, password we are giving and we are signing in. Then we will attach. We will attach to our application. Then inside the service text plus, we will create our problems like that reported by category. This all are in our service text. Like this we will activate. This is our workflow. If in case there is any exception, we are creating exception also. It will handle our exception also. Then we are doing logout, then terminate. So this is our workflow monitor. Like this we will launch, we will attach, we will log in into the workflow monitor. Here we are getting the information about the failed jobs. Like this we are using recover and exception also. Recover is nothing but when we will get an exception, it will directly catch the and it will solve. Then terminate. Like that search image is used for our getting the failed job information. So this is how my process look like and my object looks like. Now I'm going to show you how my process will run. This is my process. Now I'm going to run this process and I will show how it will run. Let's see. Now it's going to start. My process is start. First it attached and it is the Power Center workflow monitor. Here we will login into the Informatica repository. Here it's getting the credentials. It will automatically get the username and password and it will login into the repository. It will take some time. Here we will get all the information about the failed job and about the technicians. In status, we will get the fail jobs. It will take some time. What's going on? Okay, now you can see it's logging in. Now we will get all the jobs from the repository. Here it will check all the failed jobs and we will get all the information. Here we get the all the jobs. It's checking the failed jobs. Is there any failed job or not? Like that it's checking. It got a failed job. Then all the information, all the details of the failed job and about the technician detail. It will take the data and then it will go to the Service Desk Plus application. Now through credential it will log in automatically. Just 1 minute. Yeah, it log in into the Service Desk Plus. This is our environment, Service Desk environment. Here we will create a problem. We will select problem, we will create a new problem. Then we will fill all the details that is reported by category, subcategory, items, everything we will select. We will select the emergency, impact, priority, everything, technician name, that is Sunil Kumar. Then we will describe the description. Then we will send a mail to the assigned technician, that is Sunil Kumar, and it is assigned successfully. So as we can see how our process is working in Blue Prism 2, how it is logging into the remote desktop, how it's going to the information repository and getting the information about the failed job and the person and the technician person and assign and raise a ticket to a person. So now at this time you will get so many exceptions, like sometime we can't connect to remote desktop, sometime we will not get failed job, sometime we will not get detail of the person to whom we have to assign. Like that problem we can face. So as a human, an employee can do all these things by our own. Sometime We can know the problem, why it's not connecting, and handle those problems. But robot can't understand these problems. So for this, we have to keep the exceptions. In this exception stage, we will handle all these problems. We will keep the solution for this problem. We will check what is the problem, and we will, through this problem, we will go to the solution. Like this we handle. In our use case, we handle so many exceptions, like these are the three exceptions I show you. Remote desktop, if in case we are not connected to remote desktop, what to do, what not to do, that we will do in our exception. Like this, in failed job also, we give an exception stage. And if in case we are not getting the detail of the question, at that time also what the robot should do, we assign to the robot by using the exception stages. So what is the advantages of our use case? As we know, this is a manual task and this is a repeated task, and human will do repeatedly same job. It will go and it will check the failed job detail and send a mail to the technician. This is a boring and repetitive task. So in case of a human, one robot can do this work easily and all the time without any loss of time. So it mainly reduces the cost, because robot can do this work more error freely and very fastly than a human. It increases the accuracy. As I told you, it is do error freely because robot will do exactly what we will assign. But in case human can do the mistake, but robot will not do. And also one more important thing, it reduces the team member. If in case we are using 10 team members to do the L1 support work, we can reduce it to 50%, and we can assign this work to our robot. So finally, my conclusion is that we define the virtual workforce to automate the L1 works to reduce the human effect. Humans should do some tasks which is more attractive and creative, not like repetitive and boring tasks. We also define the solution to reduce the cost of the company. Thank you.